So as the recording of this video, the Bleach, the second season, or Core 2, or whatever you want to call it, the separation is coming out within more, as of the recording of this video anyway, in more than 70 days. And of course, with a lot of speculation, a lot of talk, a lot of which will be the extended fight, which I've done somewhat of a video on what I think it will be. I think it's time to bring it down a little bit of a notch to think about more so what is the extended fight, or the added fight, I should say, and talk a little bit more about what we expect the anime to do previous current fights that we already know that are going to happen better, potentially. So that's what this video is going to be a little bit about. If you enjoyed this type of content, of course, like, subscribe, all that good stuff helps in the algorithm and whatnot. And of course, let's get into it, shall we? Now, the way I've done this video is kind of predict where I think it's going to end, and it's a little bit difficult and where I think it's going to end. Going off absolutely nothing at all, I'm going to assume that they're going to make the invasion of the Soul Palace either the last episode fight, or they're going to end it off there. And if they do make it into a fight in general, they're going to have to go into the next volume and then skip a bunch of other fights, which they did in Core 1 as well, like with the Komamura going to see his dad and X, Y, and Z. That might be a spoiler for anime onlys, but that was in the volume after. It doesn't really matter. It's convoluted. We'll just ignore that. But that's where I'm going to kind of go into the fight. So no zombie Bambietta, thank God. I hope she doesn't come up in Core 2. I'm not ready for that. And also no zombie Toshiro. I'm specifically going from the first invasion of where Yuha kind of appeared in the Soul Palace. That's where I'm going to go, because that's where I personally believe it's going to end. And plus, I have an idea roughly on where episodes are going to be and what fights are going to be in them. So again, I'm making prediction off of that as well. So again, I could be completely wrong, but we'll go with it anyway. Now, first and foremost, I'm going to name all the fights that I believe are going to happen as it does in the manga, with not much change at all. Of course, we appreciate some Sakuga, but in terms of like added choreography or added bits of information or what, I don't think that these fights are going to get it in general. So I'll just name a few, such as Basby versus Toshiro, Soifon versus BG9, Bambietta versus Komamura, Master Masculine's whole thing against with Shuhei, Kensei, Rose, Renji. I think that that's all going to play out as it does. Rukia versus Asuna, I think is going to be the same. Ichigo versus the Bambiettas, I think is the same as well. Ichigo versus the Seven, as brief as that was, I still think, because of the context of like him and Uryu and the speed of which things happen, I think that that's going to pretty much stay the same as well. And that's pretty much the more notable fights I really want to talk about. Of course, there's Yatsura and Isane versus the Visionary. But again, I think that that's going to stay the same as well. However, there's about four notable fights, not including the added one that we're going to be getting, that I feel like is going to have a little bit more of an improvement or a little bit more context. And first and foremost, this one's least likely than all the others, but I wanted to mention it anyway, and that is Kangdu versus Rangiku. Now, of course, we didn't really get to see these two fight literally at all. We see Toshiro basically close to being on his deathbed, and then Kangdu appears next to Basby and drops Rangiku on her neck to where it looks like she's got like an impaled throat. Now, I'm fine with it happening the way that it does. I think it gives a little bit of a shock factor in terms of Toshiro and the audience for the manga at the time. But I do feel like, especially with Rangiku in this arc, she doesn't really do much. And Kubo kind of insinuated that Rangiku would be doing something within this arc back in like 2013. I think it was a Germany interview. I'm not quite sure. But to give her a little bit of limelight or a bit of character, a bit of something, would go a long way, especially for Rangiku fans. And while it is very shock value in the manga, I feel like it can add a lot of padding as well into an episode if they wish to give Rangiku some love against Kangdu and see how she got that impaled throat, so to say. But other than that, it is more so of, it would be nice, but not necessary. The next one I want to put on the list, of course, is a Bambietta fight, because of course I'm biased. But in terms of Bambietta versus Shinji and not Komamura, while Komamura and Shinji kind of appear at the same time, I do think it might be a smart kind of opportunity to maybe delay Komamura's appearance to give Shinji and Bambietta a little bit of time to fight and have a little bit of an exchange of words, because Shinji, again, in this arc is a bit of a jobber, so to say. He's liked, but he just doesn't do the job correctly, other than doing the job of looking like a rat, so to say. So I really want Shinji to have a little bit of time to shine here. Yeah, he does a bit of mind fuckery with Bambietta, which is cool, and I do think that Bambietta does go into Volstandig a lot prematurely, so I would like to see her, you know, actually fight before she goes Volstandig. I know she's got anger issues and whatnot, but I'd like to see them two kind of throw it back and forth before she gets really angry and then goes Volstandig and hits Shinji and then goes to Komamura. So again, I would like to see a lot of that, and I do think there is opportunity for it. Again, the reason why I mention this is because of like the new, I guess you could say, voice line within the trailer that people have speculated is potentially going to be the extended fight or even added fight. I'm more so on the fence now. I'm not actually quite sure. It is really a mystery and it's interesting. But based off that one line that is new that wasn't in the manga, I'm going to assume that there's going to be maybe some extra content regarding those two. And I hope so too, because I love Bambiera. So please, Taguchi, Kubo, do Bambi justice, because you're about to do a dirty in Core 3 and I'm going to be a very sad man. Next on the list is Kenpachi versus Gremmy. And look, I'm just going to come out and say this is probably going to be one of the episodes of the season that is going to be more taken care of than most. And because of that, I expect probably a bit more content than what we got in the manga. Based on that, off absolutely nothing at all. We did get that in Yuha versus Yamamoto. Got some extra content with a little bit of the flashbacks. And I hope we get some within Kenpachi versus Gremmy too, considering the context of what I hear about this episode. I do hear some very good things. Now, when I look at the manga, and I'm not counting the Yatra and Isane versus, you know, the Visionary, I'm not counting all of that, right? But the reason why I say is because as I was skimming through the manga to make sure I got all the fights that I wanted to cover and talk about, is that other than Gremmy kind of like talking to himself, it's just Kenpachi swinging his sword while things are being thrown at him, such as lava, water, space, all these sort of things. You know, the casual shit talking from Kenpachi is there as well, and I do feel like it is an episode's worth of content. I might even say an episode and a half, considering depending on what they do with the Yachiru and Isane stuff going into it and leading into it, and then towards like Kenpachi being attacked by the Bambis as well. It's gonna be interesting to see how they pace things. I mean, it can be extremely fast paced, and I hope that they do have a lot of creative freedom. But even reading some of these pages and some of these chapters, everything is just so quick and everything is just so random and thrown out there, and that's the point, because that's the imagination of Gremmy. So I do feel like there's going to be a lot of creativity into this fight. I do feel like there's going to be a lot of added content or context, especially with Kenpachi's fighting style, and maybe some emotional ties with even Yachiru to some degree, because this is probably going to be one of the last times we do see it for quite a while, until maybe Core 4. Maybe that was a bit of a spoiler, but oh well, once you know, you'll know. Trust me, it makes sense and you'll enjoy it regardless. But with a fight with so little dialogue, I do generally think that, you know, there's a lot of creative freedom in terms of the writing. Hiramitsu, if he's still on the team, I think he is, he's gonna have a lot of creativity in regards to that. Taguchi's gonna have a lot of creativity on that, and whatever animator is working on that is going to have a lot of creativity, and they're going to have to either stretch it out for a whole entire episode, which I think they could do, but I feel like it's going to go into an episode and a half. Unironically, much like Unohana versus Kenpachi in Core 1, because that was like half an episode and then went into a full one. So, well, kind of a full one, but who's counting minutes, right? So I do think that that is going to be a really good fight that I expect to have some added content in. Now, this one is going to be one where I think all the fans synonymously want, because it was taken from us. I remember the chapter reviewing days. I remember when it came out, and I still see it to this day. And that is Ichigo versus the Seven, which is the Seven Quincy's. You know, the Bambis, Basby, Pepe, Nananana, and Robert. Now, while I don't think Ichigo versus the Seven is going to be added per se, and I think it's going to focus more on speed and urgency in terms of direction, I do feel like the fight coming after that, which is the six Soul Reapers, Byakuya, Rukia, Renji, Shunshuhei, Yumichika, and Ikkaku, those six Soul Reapers versus the seven Quincy's needs to, in my mind anyway, needs to be elaborated on. I need that fight. I need that group battle, because that has so much creativity and so much going on that it can really be a nice battle royale that we never really get in Bleach, because Bleach is always 1v1 fights or 2v1 or 2v2. We never get that battle royale type feel. And I feel like, you know, the Soul Reapers versus the Quincy's, the six versus the seven can really give an amazing opportunity for that to happen. And it's possibly even our only opportunity up until we get to like Gerard, where it's like 3v1. But still, you kind of get the context. And I'm very excited if they do that. I'm going to be extremely pumped for that, because it's funny, we do see a little bit of that fight. Like, we see the starting of that fight go down as Ichigo runs to Uryu. We see a smidgen of, like, Ikkaku jumping, Shuhei doing something. And then it cuts away into Ichigo versus Uryu, if you want to even call it that. And then towards the end, it has, you know, Renji in his Bankai form, having like a confrontation with Basby about like his eyebrows, I believe, going off memory. And I'm just like, oh, so we're just gonna skip that entire fight, which I hope isn't the case, because it happens, it's shown to happen, and then it's shown to somewhat end to, I think it ends with Basby doing like a burner finger four on Renji, and that's it. Nothing really happens. And then the next thing we see is Ikkaku and Yumichika versus Giselle, versus Toshiro. Well, Giselle and Toshiro. So it's kind of like, oh, so they're fine. So what happened in that 6-7 fight? So I really hope it gives us that extension that we all wanted back in that day when that chapter first came out and we were robbed, you know. And I do think people on Twitter would really appreciate it, and people in the community, people would just talk about it all the time, and it would be a spectacle. It really would. So please let that happen. Let it happen. And I suppose people want to talk about Ichigo versus Uryu. Now, for some reason, people were gaslighting on Twitter a lot that Ichigo and Uryu was going to be a thing, was going to be the extended fight. I don't know what this was based off of, because when I look at the chapter itself, all Uryu does is shoot an arrow and then like a rain of arrows, and then Orihime shields Ichigo, and then Ichigo and Uryu have like a little bit of a yell back and forth, and that's it. Like, Yuha takes him to the Soul Palace, and then bing, bang, bosh. And it's not even a fight, it's just a delay or a kind of like countermeasure towards Ichigo getting close to Yuha at that time. So I don't really see any type of, I guess, opening even for a confrontation, even if that confrontation was going to happen, right? Let's say I'm Kubo, or let's say I'm Taguchi, and I wanted that confrontation between Ichigo and Uryu to happen. One, I don't think Ichigo would even attack Uryu at that point in the story, because he's, well, for one, in shock, and he can't believe that this is happening. His focus would be on Yuha, not Uryu. And all that Uryu will be doing is probably attacking or just defending, and Ichigo isn't going to want to attack Uryu anyway. So I don't think there's going to be a fight nor confrontation. And I, you know, you have to think, how's Orihime and Chad going to come into the mix of that? And I do think that that's going to be a very short interaction, and that's how an episode is going to end, rather than it start something big. So unfortunately, I just don't see that fight happening. So I feel like the main things that I'm talking about is Bambita versus Shinji, maybe some Rangiku versus Kangdu, Gremi versus Kenpachi, I think is really more so on my radar of like possibility. And then of course we have the 6 Zoroapas versus the 7 Quinces, which is really something like I'm coping on that we get. So other than that, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Go read the manga. Tell me what you think is going to get extended, or what you'd like to be extended. Again, of course, I'm coming from the mindset that this is going to end when Yuha gets to the Quincy Palace, and that's it. I'm not talking about Kurinji versus Yuha, or Hakifune versus, you know, Yuha, or any of the squad members versus Yuha. I'm talking specifically from when he enters. Hopefully I'll get proven wrong or right. I don't know. I wouldn't mind either. But that's the perspective I'm coming from. With that being said, if you like the video, of course, do all that nice jazz with the subscriptions and the commenting. That being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.